Good morning viewers and students. I am Dr. P. Jamuna Devi from PG and Research Department of Mathematics, ADM College for Women, Autonomous Nagapattinam. Today we are going to see about the course Astronomy. Today I am going to present in the module 1 some basic definitions of celestial spheres, dip of horizon and something about some interesting facts about astronomy. Astronomy is a branch of mathematics. Already we know that mathematics is a queen of science. In this, astronomy is a branch of science which deals with celestial objects, space and the physical universe as a whole. Astronomy is a natural science that studies celestial objects and phenomena. In this, astronomy we use mathematics, physics and chemistry in order to explain the origin and evolution. It is a useful and interesting topic. We have placed this course in 3rd BSc Mathematics 6th semester. And the objects of interest include planets, moons, stars, nebulae, galaxies and comets. In this module, we are going to see some basic definitions of astronomy, that is about celestial spheres, axis, about hemispheres and what is the dip of horizon and all. First of all, I am going to start about the definition of celestial sphere. What is celestial sphere? It is an imaginary sphere in which an observer is a center and all other celestial objects are fixed. An imaginary is a center and on which all celestial objects are considered to lie. We are going to see in a diagrammatical representation. This is a celestial sphere. We know here we consider Earth as a celestial sphere which lies in the center, and the other blue part is the what we call it as universe. Generally it's known as celestial sphere. In this, the center line which you see is called the pole. It is a fixed line. We know that Earth rotates about, it's tilted 23 degree and a half degree. The line which touches the north celestial sphere is called north celestial pole, and the axis which touch the southern part of the celestial sphere is called south celestial pole. The line which is parallel, which is parallel to the pole is called celestial equator. It divides the celestial sphere into two equal parts. The Earth rotation is from west to east. Next, we are going to see the definition of diurnal motion. Diurnal motion is a daily motion of stars and other celestial bodies across the sky. Celestial bodies includes bodies like other planets like stars, moon, etc. The motion is due to Earth's rotation from west to east, as I already said, which causes celestial bodies to have an apparent motion from east to west. So this is a beautiful representation of a picture taken from the Himalayan region. In this, the spotlights is, they are the motion of the stars which we have captured, which the scientists captured in the footsteps of Himalayas. Here one side real day equal to 23.934496 hours, but usually we say 24 hours, but it's not exactly 24. It is 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds. A side real day is approximately 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4.0905 seconds. This long exposure photo of the northern night sky above the Himalayan shows the apparent paths of the stars as Earth rotates. This diagram represents the axis, pole, equator, north celestial pole and south celestial pole. So let's see detailly. Now I have considered the celestial celestial object as Earth. You can see the blue planet. This is Earth. You can see some parts of South America and all. The center line which is perpendicular to the pole is called perpendicular orbit. The line which is tilted, is called the axis line. So here we can see the north celestial pole and south celestial pole. This line which is parallel to the perpendicular line is called line of ecliptic. The circle which is parallel to the pole is called celestial equator. The angle between the perpendicular line and the north celestial pole is called angle of obliquity. Next. Here we can see a clear description of a man standing on the celestial sphere. So here I am going to define what is zenith and an order. Here you can see an observer standing on the celestial pole. You can imagine a plumb line from the observer's position. The top point is called zenith and the bottom point is called an order. The direction of the plumb line and the position of the observer produced both ways meet the celestial sphere at two points, Z and N. The point Z above the observer is called zenith. The point beneath him is called the nadir point. Here you can see the horizontal line. Actually, an observer below the horizon, he cannot see the objects. So, I will tell it in the next slide. It is called invisible horizon. Next, we can see what is cardinal points. The celestial equator and the horizon meets at two point, east and west point. Here in this diagram, you can see where is the celestial equator. A celestial equator and the horizon meets at two points, E and W. Both are called east and west points. Similarly, the meridian meets the horizon at north and south point, N and S. So, this altogether, these four points are called cardinal points. Next, we are going to see what is hemisphere. The celestial equator divides the celestial sphere into two regions. The region which contains the north pole is called northern hemisphere, and the region which contains the south pole is called southern hemisphere. Similarly, the meridian divides the celestial sphere into two regions. The region which contains the west point is called western hemisphere, and the region which contains the east point is called eastern hemisphere. Now we can see which is visible and invisible. Yes, you can imagine an observer standing on the celestial pole. If the region below the horizon, the observer cannot view. Only the region above the horizon only he can view. The horizon divides the celestial sphere into two hemispheres. The observer on the surface of the sphere cannot see the objects in the hemisphere below the horizon. So, we can see which is visible hemisphere and invisible hemisphere. Next, we can come to the first point of Aries and first point of Libra. The first point of Aries is also known as cusp of Aries. It's the location of the vernal equinox. Next, we are going to see what is the equinox and autumnal equinox and all. So, we have to concentrate on what is first point of Aries and first point of Libra. In this diagram, you can see the ecliptic line and celestial equator. You can see the red color point which denotes the sun. When it moves from east to west, it cuts the ecliptic at omega point. Omega point is called first point of Aries. And when it meets the southern region, it cuts the ecliptic region at omega, delta, that is called first point of Libra. Equinoxes and solstices. There are only two times of year when the Earth's axis is tilted neither towards nor away from the sun, resulting in a nearly equal amount of daylight and darkness of the latitudes. You can see in some places we are celebrating equinoctial day and all. In that, we can see the quantity of daytime and nighttime will be equal. So that is called in some days we have a long night and a shortest day. Times in a year when the axis is tilted near towards north away from the sun, resulting in a nearly equal amount of daylight and darkness of the latitudes. These events are referred to as equinoxes. The word equinox is derived from the Latin words equal and night. So in March 21 we get equinox day. Sun comes to the first point of Aries during spring season. In autumn season also we'll get another equinox, autumnal equinox. It falls on September 23, where the sun comes to the first point of Libra during autumn season. The solstices, summer, the solstices falls on summer and winter season on June 21 and December 22. The summer solstice occurs at the moment at the earth tilt towards the sun is at a maximum. The summer solstice occurs when the sun is directly over the Tropic of Cancer. The sun is the highest point in the sky and this is the longest day of the year. During the longest day of the year, the duration of night is very short and the duration of day is longest. For example, we can see in the places of Australia, Chile, southern Brazil and north southern South Africa. This diagram clearly describes the season, four seasons. Autumn season, summer, spring and winter. The center portion is the sun's position. The season is caused due to the angle, the tilted angle of the earth. So, from this you can see 23.5 degree from plane of ecliptic. When the sun is very close to the earth, we get winter and spring seasons. When it is far away, we get summer and autumnal equinox. So, the beginning of summer falls on June 21 and beginning of winter falls on June 22. This diagram also describes the summer solstice, winter solstice, spring equinox and autumnal. We are going to see about celestial coordinates. Like in a graph sheet, how do we have an x-axis and y-axis? In the universe also, we have coordinates. We are called celestial coordinates. We have four types of coordinates. First one is horizontal system. In this, horizon is taken as a reference circle. Azimuth A and altitude are the coordinates. Second one is the equatorial system. In this, the equatorial line is the reference circle. Right ascension A and declination delta are the coordinates. The third type is the meridian system. In this, the meridian is the reference circle. In this, hover angle H and declination del are the coordinates. Fourth type, this one is the last type. In this, first point of Aries is taken as the reference, and celestial longitude lambda and latitude beta are the coordinates. So now we are going to see what is dip of horizon. Imagine an observer on the surface of the earth. He cannot see the objects below the horizon. As we said, below the horizon, it is called invisible horizon, which is the tangent plane to the earth at its position. Consider it is an elevated position. He can see objects below the ordinary horizon, the new zone of visibility being defined by the tangents from the observer to the surface of the earth. The curve passing through the point of contact to these tangents is called visible horizon. The angle between the direction of ordinary horizon and the visible horizon is called dip of horizon. This diagram clearly explains you what is dip of horizon. You can imagine an observer standing on the earth in the position AB. From A, the tangent line, you can that is a visible horizon, and from B, it is called the direction of ordinary horizon. To find an expression for the dip of horizon, let E be the center of earth and A its radius. Let A be the position of the observer at the surface of the earth, and B his position at a height h above the surface of earth. BT is the tangent from B on the surface of earth, and BX is the direction of the ordinary horizon, so that dip D equal to angle of XBT. D equal to angle BET. From Pythagoras, BT square equal to B square minus AD square, because we get a right angle triangle there. So we get A plus H whole square minus A square. So altogether, at last we get 2AH. Therefore, BT equal to root of 2AH. Since H is small compared to A, BT is called the distance of visible horizon from the observer. Using dip of horizon, we can find the distance between two mountains whose tops are just visible from each other. This is one application of what we have studied till now. You imagine a mountain from A1, B1 and A2, B2. Let A1, B1 and A2, B2 be the mountains of height H1 and H2 whose tops B1, B2 are just visible from each other. Therefore, B1, B2 must be the tangent of the earth. Let it touch the surface of earth at T. Distance between mountain is the arc A1 and A2. We are going to calculate arc A1 and A2 only. You can divide into two. Arc A1T plus arc A2T equal to B1T plus B2T is nearly. From the definition of dip of horizon, we know that it is root of 2AH. So, the distance is H1 and H2. So, we get the root of 2AH1 plus root of 2AH2. So, thank you so much for listening to the module 1. We will see in the module 2 in the next video. Thank you.